Yeti. Storytelling, wearing accessories and stamping around, could be the oldest art forms among humans. Some skilled storytellers preserve and transmit communal history and knowledge as they entertain, for example, before bedtime. The Yeti was a protected species in Nepal as recently as 1958. Some think this elusive, mysterious creature is found in the snowy Himalayas. For generations, the Sherpas of Tibet have refrained from climbing Mount Kambila in eastern Nepal, for fear that Yetis would come and punish them. You see, Yetis are most often described by those who claim to have seen them as between 2 and 4 meters tall. And Tibetan lamas say a Yeti carries a magic stone in his left armpits, and throws it at great yaks, in order to stun and kill them. The Yeti was observed twice in eastern Tibet by Reinhold Messner, a leading mountaineer. The huge ape-like creature was also spied in Nepal by the British mountaineer Don Willans in 1970, when it was making off across the southern slope of Mount Annapurna, while clutching a bag of English chocolate bars, taken from the mountaineer's tent. Genuine Yeti specimen and authenticated photos seem absent. In May 2012, investigators, led by University of Oxford genetics professor Brian Sykes, sent out a request to museums and individual collectors, including the renowned mountaineer Reinhold Messner, and got 3 hair samples in good enough shape to allow gene sequencing. These samples were said to be from Yetis. But one of them came from a goat, and the other 2, one from Ladakh in India and the other from Bhutan, were linked to the polar bear. The hairs might have come from a distant descendant of the polar bear or a local cross with a brown bear, the scientists suggested. Might have come from Ziz looks like a little speculation. The facts are, 3 hair samples are investigated and ruled out. But the samples are few. The findings are therefore far from being conclusive evidence whether there are snow bears walking about in Tibet or not. And now for good old Yeti tales from Tibet. This tale I'm about to share here is adapted from a popular textbook, Tibetan English Folk Tales, 2006, edited by Ali Stewart, Kevin Stewart, C. Bangradurji, and others. Tale of the Yeti and the Old Man, also known as Yeti Protection. Once an old man from Nepal carried a large sack of corn through the forest to his small abandoned mill to grind it into flour. But before his task was finished, it was dusk already, so he had no choice but to spend the night there at that place. In the dead of night, when the old man lay curled up next to his small fire on the floor of the mill shack, he suddenly woke up. A huge ape-like creature with white shaggy fur was standing over him, thundering. "Who are you and what do you want here?" "I only want to grind my corn," squeaked the villager. "This is my hiding place," snarled the Yeti. "No one sees me and leaves here alive." The man was very scared, but an idea came to his mind. "Great Yeti," he began, "it is a Tibetan custom to anoint one's legs before dying. Please, let me perform these rites before you take my life." The surprised Yeti nodded, it was okay. So the man sat down and started rubbing butter on his legs, massaging both sides. "This is how we scent ourselves before death, big one. Then our well-oiled legs swiftly and easily carry us wherever we wish to go. Let me try some of that," bellowed the Yeti and sat down with a thump. What he did not notice was that the old man massaged his swollen, hairy legs with pine resin from the rucksack, and not butter. Then the man took a burning firebrand and held it near his own legs, and the butter streamed down. The Yeti did likewise with a flaming stick. But as soon as he held it next to his legs, the pine resin flared up and his whole body seared up into flames. Screamingly, he leapt away into the forest and was not seen again. There is a Yetier fear in the back of everyone's mind, but the blessed are not haunted by it. Old Sherpa wisdom. If you wish your own true experience or any folk tales, legends to be read, animated and illustrated here, then please kindly share your them to zen123@gmail.com. Also mention how you want your name to be credited in the video. Lastly, if you want to, then please click like, share and subscribe. It's free, doesn't cost money, but can make a difference to the channel, helping me provide better quality for my next videos. Thank you. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Should you have any questions, please comment below. And to share your story, please contact hearsunny@zen123@gmail.com. Thank you.